review.
Good evening. Hey, birthday girl. We'll start by saluting the flag.
To the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Approval.
Approval of the agenda. Palmer? Roll call, Palmer?
I believe you have to have a motion before you do roll call.
Do I have a motion to do the roll?
To approve
the agenda?
There is, I will make the first motion on the floor to approve tonight's agenda.
I will make a motion to approve tonight's agenda as presented.
Do I have a second?
Second motion.
Roll call. Mullen.
Aye.
Virginia.
Who was the second?
Jose.
She was?
Mr. Tapia.
Okay. Aye.
Colonel?
No.
Jose Tapia? And me is an
aye? Aye.
Okay, so me is an aye, four. For one. Okay. Welcome to the meeting of the Fairfax Elementary School District Board of Trustees. This meeting is held in compliance with the state of California and county of current sunshine law. We have a place on the agenda to hear from members of the public who attend our meeting. It is good if you can call the superintendent before the meeting and have a place in the agenda for any issues you want to talk about. However, if you haven't done that, you may fill out a form provided for you and give it to the board before the meeting begins. Each item and the agenda can be discussed by members of the public. 20 minutes are provided for each agenda item. Several people can speak during those 20 minutes. We do hope that you attendance will refrain from visiting during this meeting, as this can be disrupting to the board members. Thank you for being here.
Mrs. Rios, we can hardly hear you. So if you can bring the microphone closer or take the mask off, I think the community would appreciate that.
Good. Like this. Okay, so public comment?
We do have public comments. First, we have Marissa Wood.
The copy of my speech. I'm going to tell you, I timed it and it was over 3 minutes. It's about 3 minutes and 46 seconds so that I won't be interrupted. I'd like to ask if I could have the 4 minutes.
I'm going to make a motion for you to be able to finish your entire statement.
Thank you, Victoria.
Second.
Roll call, Mullen.
Aye. Aye.
Lawson.
Aye.
Cornell.
Aye.
Tapia.
Aye.
Okay.
Thank you. Good evening, honorable trustees, Victoria Cornell and Virginia Lawson.
Oh, she said yes.
I think you're next.
Charlie and Fairfax community and staff. Moland, Rios, and Tapia, I would like to remind you that you are being investigated for fraudulent and unethical practices by the grand jury, Kern County Superintendent of Schools, and the FPPC. I understand that Alma is accomplished at Googling, but I did take the liberty of Googling the following information for you in case you were unaware of the repercussions you three are facing from these investigations. When the FPPC finds you guilty, which you are, you will pay fines or penalties. Some penalties in other similar cases totaled $150,000. When the Kern County Superintendent of Schools finds you guilty, which you are, you, control of the board, will be taken from you and given to an outside source. When the grand jury finds you guilty, which you are, you will be indicted. An indictment is rendered when a grand jury has determined that a serious crime has occurred and there is enough evidence to suggest that the defendants committed it. Next, the defendants are formally charged with a felony. Then begins the process in which defendants are arraigned and can either enter a plea or go to trial. Your decision to not offer the superintendent position to Laura Brown, your number two candidate, after your number one candidate wisely turned you down, proves once again that you are working in collusion to advance a personal revenge agenda. Do you honestly believe that no one sees this? Do you truly think that just because you can enact your Machiavellian plan, that you are justified in doing so? I caution you to heed my previous words and understand what you will be facing as you continue to threaten our students' education. We are all watching you, and you will be held accountable. In conclusion, I just want to share with you what happened, some words that the current legal counsel shared with me as he was leaving the board meeting last week. I asked him how he was able to sleep at night knowing his part in the excessive legal fees totaling $203,000 that was stolen from our students. In reply, this LA lawyer flippantly said to me, "My part's only $2,000. The 200, can you believe that, man? What would you do with that $2,000 for your family? But to him, it was nothing. The $203,000 was used to defend the criminal behavior of Tapia, Rios, and Moland. That equates to $1,000 stolen from 200 families. His insensitivity, hubris, and greed were appalling. Shame on you, Tapia, Rios, and Moland, for using our students' education fund as your personal bank account. We will not stop fighting for our students as you continue to put their education at risk. You will answer for the havoc you have rendered on this district and our students."
We have Pam Padilla.
I'm doing a translation.
Buenas
noches, honorarios fideicomiso Victoria Cordeo, Virginia Lassam, Superintendent Brown, comunidad y personal de Fairfax. Moland, Rios, Tapia, me gustaría recordarles que el gran jurado, el superintendente de las escuelas del condado de Kern, los está investigando por prácticas fraudulentas y por pocas éticas. La FPPC entiende que se ha desempeñado en que Alma se ha desempeñado en Google. Sin embargo, me tomé la libertad de buscar en Google la siguiente información en caso de que no estuvieran conscientes de las precauciones que están enfrentando. Cuando la FPPC los encuentre culpable, lo que es la violación de pagar multas o sanciones, algunas multas han sido de hasta de $150,000. Cuando el Kern County Superintendent de Escuelas los encuentre culpables, lo quitarán del cual es usted un fraude, malversación de fondos u otras prácticas fiscales ilegales. Le quitarán el control de la junta y los entregarán a una entidad extraña. Cuando el gran jurado los declare culpable, lo cual es un fraude, coalición, malversación de fondos de estudiantiles para nombrar solo algunos. Pero el proceso, una acusación formal ocurre cuando un gran jurado ha determinado que lo ocurrido un delito es grave y hay suficiente evidencia para seguir que los acusados lo cometieron luego. Los acusados son acusados formalmente de un delito grave. El proceso comienza en el que los acusados son procesados y pueden declararse culpables o ir a un juicio. Su decisión no ofrece el puesto de superintendente. Su posición de no ofrecer el puesto de superintendente a Laura Brown, su candidata número dos, después de que su candidata número uno lo rechazó sabiendo, demuestra una vez más que ustedes están trabajando en convivencia para promover la agenda de vergüenza personal. ¿De verdad crees que nadie lo ve, que ve esto? ¿De verdad creen que solo por eso puedes poner en práctica su plan macabro? No están justificados para hacerlo. Les advierto que presente atención a mis palabras anteriores, a comprender lo que les enfrenta mientras continúa amenazando la educación de nuestros estudiantes. Todos estamos observando, ustedes serán responsables. Lo último, quiero compartir con ustedes las palabras del último, una serie de asesoría legal que iniciará. Cuando salía de la última reunión de junta, le pregunté cómo podría dormir las noches sabiendo que esta junta fraudulenta acaba de robar $203,000 a nuestros estudiantes, $203,000 en honorarios legales excesivos aprobado por Molen Tapia Ríos, todos los cuales fueron acurridos para defender los principales de Palmer Molen, sus acusaciones abusivas y fraudulentas. En respuesta de este abogado de Los Ángeles, les dijo con ligereza: mi parte solo son $2,000. ¿Puedes creer eso? ¿Que podrían ser todos los estudiantes por sus familias con solo $2,000? $203,000 utilizados para defender la conducta criminal de Tapia Molen Ríos equivale a $1,000 robados a 200 familias. Sus insensibles arrogancias y codicia son espantosas. Deberías darle vergüenza. ¿Qué vergüenza, Tapia Ríos Molen, por usar el fondo de la educación de nuestros estudiantes como su propia cuenta bancaria personal? No dejemos de luchar por nuestros estudiantes. Mientras ustedes ponen su educación en riesgo, ustedes responderán por el bajo que se rindiendo en este distrito. Nuestros estudiantes primero.
Next we have Pamela Padilla.
Padilla.
Good evening. I want you to realize something and let it sink in. The man you wanted to hire for superintendent came and sat in on one of the board meetings and decided less than an hour that he was not going to accept the position. He turned to us and said, good luck, then left. I don't blame him. So now that he's gone, we have the task of picking a new candidate. Luckily for us, there was more than one person that has gone through the application and interview process. Our very own Laura Brown. She was a worthy applicant and has the experience to serve our district well. Now, before you snub the idea, consider this. I can count more than a dozen times where members of the board have turned to Laura for advice or direction in the meeting. She does a good job of remaining neutral and undertaking her duties for the district. Ms. Rios, please consider how much she has helped you, and you can help her too by letting her continue to move the district in the right direction. Don't listen to what anyone else tells you about her and use your own experiences to make a decision. Despite the chaos on the district and Mr. Coleman retiring, she has kept her eyes forward and worked remarkably in getting things together for the new school year. We, the community, endorse and support Laura Brown for superintendent. Thank you.
Next, we have Lisa Smith. Lisa, you're online, so just give me 1 second. Lisa, are you there?
I'm here. Can you see me and hear me okay?
Yes, we can.
Okay, excellent. Do we have an interpreter this evening?
Yes.
Okay, yes. So I'll be pausing occasionally so the interpreter can help members of the audience and the board if they need the interpretation. So good evening, Mr. Clark, Mrs. Rios, and members of the board. I'm excluding Mrs. Lawson and Ms. Cornell from my comments tonight because I truly believe they have been acting ethically and with the best interests of our students in mind.
Gracias por dejarme hablar, aunque el señor Mullen, señora Rios y señor Tapia van a decir. No van a escuchar mis palabras.
Actually, I'm excluding Mrs. Lawson and Mrs. Coronel from my comments. So my comments are for Mrs. Rios, Mr. Tapia, and Mr. Moland.
You can go ahead and speak. I'll translate what you're saying.
Thank you. Mr. Moland, Mrs. Rios, and Mr. Tapia, I will say that I have very little hope that you will hear my words or respond to the will of the Fairfax voters who elected you. Even without your respect for my words or doing what the voters want you to do and elected you to do, I will speak my mind without fear of being sued or fired. My students matter that much to me.
That was fast.
It was what?
Yeah.
Can you repeat it again?
Could you say a few sentences at a time and then I'll translate what you're saying?
Okay. Mr. Moland, Mrs. Rios, and Mr. Tapia, I will say that I have very little hope that you will hear my words or respond to the will of the Fairfax voters who elected you.
Señor Moland, señora Rios, señor Tapia, les voy a decir que tengo poca esperanza que van a escuchar lo que voy a decir y parte de los que están votando de parte de Fairfax.
Even without your respect for my words or doing what the voters want you to do and elected you to do, I will speak my mind without being afraid of being sued or fired. My students matter that much to me.
Voy a decir lo que quiero decir sin tener miedo de que me vayan a
Cindy, can you
shut me van a o correr del distrito.
Yeah, I can't hear her.
There's too much internet going on the bandwidth. Can you shut yours off?
Yeah.
Sorry, I'm back. Or can do I need to repeat myself, or do you want me just to read it in English?
Okay, I can't. Yeah, I can't really hear her. Can't I just the? Yeah, I can hear the speaker. Yeah. Okay. Okay. At least you have.
I have this. It's that.
Are you able to hear me at all?
Yes.
Is anybody
I have your letter in Spanish, if that, I mean, English, if that's okay. You want to share what you're going to say, and then I can go through and read it in Spanish?
I'm not sure where you got the letter because I didn't send it, but I'm assuming that someone gave it to you? I don't know.
Pam has it.
Okay, then yes, I will say it in English and then you can translate it. Can you hear me, Charlie, Mr. Clark? I'm sorry, are you able to hear me?
Yes, we can hear you, Lisa. If you want to go ahead and say your whole statement and then the translator will read your letter translated.
Okay. You are here tonight to continue your work on finding a superintendent to replace Mr. Coleman. This is work you couldn't do before because you were responding to the grand jury report issued May 27, transferring two legal cases away from school's legals at a cost of numerous hours, showing up to meetings late or not at all, handing meetings over to attorneys to run instead of following your own bylaws, trying to cut off public comment and eject citizens from meetings, and trying to figure out how to pay over $11,000 to 3Fs for their emergency work on Mr. Mullen's censure. While you've been acting ridiculous, embarrassing yourself and all of us associated with this district, the employees, parents, and students of this district have had one person to count on to keep the district focused on educating students, and that's Laura Brown. You, by your actions, have snubbed her long service with this district. You've minimized her commitment to educate students. You've sidetracked her focus with grand jury requirements that are your responsibility, which she's been working tirelessly to open a school after a year of shutdown. Shame on you. You need to be ashamed of what you have done to her. I support her. People here tonight support her. They are telling you loudly and continuously what they want for the district they work and live in. Why are you afraid to do that? She's good enough to sit next to and tell Mrs. Rios how to run a meeting, giving her the words and actions for a meeting, but you can't trust her to run this district? I am amazed, and you need to be ashamed for not turning to the best resource this district has. So do the right thing, hire her for the superintendent's job, and let her continue her work focused on educating children.
I got through the first paragraph, but it's okay.
Gracias por dejarme hablar, aunque el señor Mullen, señora Ríos y el señor Tapia tengo poca esperanza que escucharán lo que voy a decir. Sin el respeto de mis palabras o sin hacer lo que quiere la comunidad que haga, voy a hablar sin tener miedo de una demanda. Mis estudiantes son importantes para mí. Están aquí hoy para seguir tratando de encontrar un superintendente para reemplazar al señor Coleman. Este es un trabajo que no pudieron hacer antes, porque estaban tratando con el gran jurado de reportes del 27 de mayo, que costó muchas horas. Llegaron a juntas tardes o no llegaron y le dieron la junta a los abogados. Y trataron de no dejar al público comentar.
No dejaron el público hablar. Y hasta sacaron miembros de la comunidad. Tratando de ver cómo iban a pagar por los $11,000 de trabajo emergencia de parte del señor Mullen. Han estado pasando vergüenza y han hecho que todos pasemos vergüenza, parte del distrito, los empleados, padres y estudiantes. Pues, todos más hemos tenido una persona en cual podemos contar y esa persona es Laura Brown. Ustedes y sus acciones no han dado cuenta al tiempo largo que tiene ella sirviendo este distrito. No han dado cuenta en vez de dar cuenta de todo lo que ella ha hecho por el distrito, ustedes se han enfocado en todos los requisitos del gran jurado. Que es responsabilidad de ustedes, aunque ella ha estado trabajando muy duro, tratar de abrir la escuela a partir de que fue cerrado por un año. ¡Qué vergüenza! Deberían de tener vergüenza de lo que le han hecho a ella. Yo la soporto. La gente que está aquí la soporta. Te están diciendo muy fuerte y continuamente lo que quieren en el distrito, que ellos trabajan y en que ellos viven. ¿Por qué tienen miedo? Ella es buena para sentarse junto a ustedes y decirle a la señora Ríos cómo correr la junta. Dándole palabras y acciones para la junta, pero no le pueden dar la confianza para correr el distrito. Deberían de tener vergüenza por no usar la ayuda que este distrito tiene, que es ella. Hagan lo que es mejor para el distrito. Denle la posición de superintendente y dejen que ella continúe a hacer su trabajo enfocándose en los niños.
Next we have Maria Hernandez.
Maria Hernandez.
I'm going to say it in English and then I'm going to say it in Spanish.
Do you want to translate?
No. I can translate myself. Thank you. I'm here to say that it seems like I don't know why you guys are having a hard time finding a superintendent when we have one here. It seems to me like at this point it's prejudice against her. And if I was her, I would sue all of you. I'm not telling her what to do. It's just my opinion as a community member, because to me, she's pretty qualified, I will say. And it's very suspicious now at this point. And it seems to me like you have prejudice against her very clearly. I wonder why, what is your guys's think about her, why you don't like her. As a taxpayer, and I live in this community, I would like to know why it's not qualified in your eyes. What has she done that it doesn't fulfill the requirements? I asked from the beginning that I wanted it to be in the commissioning or whatever to see what was wrong. And I mean, nobody was appointed from the community other than one parent, but not community members. I ask in the past, if you really think about it, I ask that I wanted it to be on it so I can be happy. So I can be at peace with your options. But of course, our concerns are never taken seriously. They're never take anything in consideration from the three main members. And you wonder why is all this propaganda against you? This is why. This is the reason why. Because you guys don't give us no answers when you guys have the chance to do it. You could have saved so much trouble, so much money. I don't know why you're hiring security every meeting. Has anybody been attacked or disrespected? If anything, we are the ones who getting disrespected by all of you, that we never get any answers from you. You always say that you understand what I'm coming from, but you always prove me wrong. ¿Cómo duerme en la noche, señor Tapia? Yo pensé que usted se corrió por los niños de migrante. ¿Y qué ha hecho por ellos? ¿Gastarse el dinero junto con los otros tres?
You have your 3 minutes.
Okay, now I'm doing it in Spanish, so you can another 3 minutes. Thank you.
Okay.
And I don't understand what I'm going to say. I'm going to translate kind of similar, not exactly. No entiendo por cuál es la razón por la que no quieren a Laura Brown para superintendent. No entiendo, no comprendo, y quiero que me den una explicación como taxpayer. Porque con mi dinero le pagan su aseguranza, señora Ríos. La del señor Mullen y la del señor Tapia. Que yo no creo que están haciendo las respuestas correctas. O que nos den una explicación como comunidad. Porque si yo fuera la señora Brown, yo pensaría que están discriminando en contra de ella. Porque ella está calificada para tener ese puesto. Y típicamente, los que se buscan casa a los que siguen para arriba, porque ella tiene trabajando 20 y pico de años. Ya que hicieron la cochinada de correr a Mr. Coleman, porque eso fue lo que pasó, lo hicieron renunciar porque él no se quería ir, porque el señor acá no se presentó, porque para eso se tiene que dar una buena apreciación y no lo hicieron. No somos tontos en la comunidad, pretendemos que somos, pero no somos. A lo mejor estamos más enterados y educados que ustedes. Y no entiendo por qué se ofuscan y se enojan cuando les pedimos algo, porque ustedes fueron elegidos por la comunidad y creo que nos merecemos una respuesta. Ustedes se habían evitado muchas cosas si hubieran hecho las cosas correctas desde el principio y trabajar en unión, no en desunión. Ahora que es usted la presidenta, quiero ver su liderazgo. I want to see what kind of leader you are. I want to see what you're made of. That you say, do you want the best for us? Show us. That's all I need to say.
For Myra Gonzalez.
To Fairfax School District, I am formally asking you, the Fairfax School District administrator in charge, to investigate and resolve the communication I received through the district email by a district employee, which was intimidating, threatening, bullying, and accusatory. On June 21st, 2021, an email was sent to me and also another employee, Martha Flores, clerk at Virginia Avenue School, written by Catherine Perseu, teacher at Fairfax School. I strongly believe that this email is inappropriate and unprofessional and violates my rights as an employee of the Fairfax School District. First, I have been placed on stress leave by my doctor since April 2021 and have not been on campus for several months and have not had no communication with my colleagues. This letter, which was emailed to me using the FSD communication system, has added to my stress and anxiety, which continues to negatively affect my health. I believe this letter is accusatory in tone and content. Ms. Persu states the following: our district is being ripped apart, and I have no doubt you are two of the most informed of all the classified. One person working with him has also violated at least two laws and will also face consequences, and I love that person even more. Secondly, I feel bullied and threatened by these statements. Quote, you can tell a tree by the fruit it bears. The fruit surrounding the school board is rotten fruit. Something has to change. Please encourage the board to file official charges of five people will be going down soon, and only three are board members. Two others will lose their jobs. One of those might face felony charges along with our board members. You cannot monkey around with public funds without felony charges. Thirdly, the toxic tone of this letter, which is hostile in nature, causes me to believe that my work environment will be negatively impacted because of abuse and intimidation of this letter. I quote, it seems as though many people either have not or cannot read the charges the grand jury has filed. If they did and could, they would see that as of yet, this something big that has been the have faith in me seems like just a stall for time, hoping the whole thing will blow over. It will not.
Do you, it's a letter and an email. Read it off.
The letter? I am writing this letter in hopes that these issues of intimidation. Bullying and threatening statements by a fellow staff member can be resolved in a professional manner that is appropriate and timely. I have worked for the district for 27 years, dedicating my efforts to assisting migrant families to receive a quality education and also ensuring that these students receive other supplemental services. My dedication to the Fairfax School District and our students has always been my goal. I am a team player and continue to provide services to the best of my ability. I believe working together as a team is the best way to move forward. Myra Gonzalez. Estimada Mesa Directiva, por medio de esta carta quiero dejarles saber que recibí una carta de la maestra Catherine Parisu y otras personas más que están detrás de esta carta, la cual fue enviada por un email del Distrito Fairfax. Esta carta me ha estresado demasiado, porque por medio de ella me están haciendo una acusación de que yo y Marta Flores tenemos el poder de manipular a la mesa directiva, que hagan cambios en los cuales se verían afectados muchas personas. Por la cual las decisiones que tomé la mesa directiva no tenemos nada que ver nosotros. Yo estoy bajo estrés causado por la señora Jennifer Davis, que me ha acosado por medio de mi trabajo en el Distrito Fairfax. Quiero que sepan que la carta enviada por medio del distrito.
Can I stop you right there? You're not translating the letter. Yeah. That's completely different statement.
This is what she wrote. I'm just reading what she wrote.
So does she need more time because the time was already taken? I mean, are you translating? What's going on?
I think you should read it.
Okay, so if it's going to be read, it needs to read, also be read in English.
Can I have 3 more minutes so she could finish reading, but Myra left?
That was the translation of the English.
Okay, read it.
It has a completely different translation. She said it was a translated letter, and it's
she wanted, I think, for you to read that one too. So I think you should keep on reading. Okay.
Okay,
keep on reading.
Okay, so I believe we would have to make a motion to allow more
Can I have a motion to give her more time so she could finish reading the paper than Myra left? Can I have a first motion?
I'm going to go ahead and make a first motion as the board bylaw gives 5 minutes.
I have a second motion?
Make that first motion.
I'll go ahead and second that.
Roll call. Mullen?
Aye.
Lawson?
Aye.
Cornell?
Aye.
Tapia?
Aye.
Permis and aye.
But please make sure that you can, if you can translate it in English as well. Thank you.
Quiero que sepan que la carta enviada por medio del distrito Fairfax fue borrada. Entraron a mi email y borraron todas las pruebas. Yo afortunadamente guardé la carta enviada por la maestra. Quiero que hagan algo al respecto de estas acusaciones y amenazas. Yo no puedo estar recibiendo este tipo de acusaciones inciertas. De antemano, gracias, Mayra González. So I'll translate the letter in Spanish. Or I'm sorry, in English. Dear school board, on behalf of this letter, I want to let you know that I received a letter from the teacher, Catherine Persu, and other people who are behind this letter. It was sent via email from Fairfax School District. This letter has stressed me out because they are accusing me. They are accusing that Martha Flores and I have the power to manipulate the school board, to make changes that can affect a lot of people. The decision why I decided to come to the school board is that we don't have anything, we have nothing to do with this. I am under a lot of stress caused by Jennifer Davis, who has accused me on behalf of my job at Fairfax. I want you to know that the letter sent on behalf of Fairfax School Board, or I'm sorry, on behalf from Fairfax District was erased. They went into my email and erased all the evidence. Luckily, I saved the letter sent by the teacher. I want you to do something in respect to the accusations and the harassment. I cannot be receiving these type of harassments. Thank you, Myra Gonzalez.
We're gonna tell the
it was all fluent here.
All right. All that was it.
Next, we have Lourdes Herrera.
Lourdes Herrera.
Oh my God.
Buenas tardes. Voy a necesitar traductor para que lo escuchen.
Traductora.
Sí. Oh. Gusta que la lea y usted me traduce o la
quiere. La puede leer. Está.
¿Qué de la es vez? En español.
Ok.
Sí. Ok. Buenas tardes. Por medio de esta carta y demás padres de familia que estamos en el programa Migrante, quiero pedirles por segunda ocasión que por favor nos escuchen y que tomen en cuenta todo lo que está pasando y que por favor hagan algo al respecto. Hace 2 años nos dirigimos hacia ustedes dejándoles saber todo lo que estaba pasando en el programa Migrante. La señora Jennifer Davis estaba haciendo pues las cosas mal desde hace 2 años. No estaba siguiendo los reglamentos del programa, no nos informaba de los eventos que se realizaban durante el programa, sobre todo de los fondos en cómo se gastaban. Prohibiendo a la trabajadora social Mayra González que nos ayudara, nos brindara cualquier servicio que nosotros necesitáramos. Desde que ella empezó este programa, le prohibió visitar las casas cuando anteriormente que estaba la señora Rita González, ella siempre le permitía acercarse a las familias, ayudarlas. Y esta señora Mayra González tiene demasiados años realizando su trabajo, aproximadamente entre 27 y 28 años. Ella sabe lo que hace y está preparada. Le quitó sus oficinas que tenía en cada una de las escuelas, que a pesar de que eran lugares pequeños, teníamos un lugar donde acudir hacia ella. Y nos dimos cuenta que sus cosas fueron sacadas de las oficinas y tiradas. Cosas personales que ella tenía ahí se perdieron. En cambio, nunca le informaron a ella que se iban a desalojar sus cosas. Simplemente se las mandó tirar. Eso no está bien lo que la señora hizo. Algunas de sus cosas pues se quebraron. Nos parece que ella es una persona racista hacia nosotros. En varias juntas no hubo traducción, no nada para nosotros de familias que necesitábamos la traducción. Nos mira como poca cosa, como si fuéramos inferiores. Nosotros necesitamos a una persona que nos entienda, nos comprenda nuestras necesidades y lo que nuestros hijos necesitan. Al igual que está el señor José Quintero, supuestamente él iba a ayudar, se le está pagando un sueldo alto, el cual no nos parece justo, porque ese sueldo que se está utilizando en él, deberían de emplearlo en los niños, en más cosas que se necesita para el programa, haciendo mejor su trabajo. Por favor, necesitamos que escuchen y que nos ayuden. Queremos que quiten a la señora Jennifer Davis y al señor José Quintero.
I would make, do you guys want to make a motion so she could finish reading the
As I stated before she began, the board bylaw states that there's 5 minutes. The agenda needs to be adjusted to modify against what the board bylaw states. So with that, she has 5 minutes if we're going by the board bylaw.
Palmer, is an aye or?
Are you asking for a motion? A motion to continue?
Yeah.
A motion to continue.
Do I have a second?
I'll second that. Please continue.
Roll call. Mullen?
Yes.
Lawson? Aye. Cornell?
Aye.
Tapia?
Aye.
Permis and aye. Proceed. Pueden seguir.
Okay, tampoco estamos de acuerdo en que sea superintendente la señora Laura Brandt. La señora Jennifer Davis, incluso a familias nuevas que están entrando al programa, las está investigando y ha hecho hasta lo imposible por sacarlas, lo cual no estamos de acuerdo en que ella esté haciendo eso. Para nosotros eso es ser racismo. Está checando todo totalmente cuando no está siguiendo los reglamentos que están en el programa Migrante. No estamos de acuerdo con que ella esté corriendo este programa. Queremos que la quiten. Y queremos que pongan a alguien que sepa, que nos escuche, que nos ponga la atención, que nosotros como padres también contamos, tenemos voz y voto y sabemos las necesidades de nuestros hijos y lo que pasa en nuestra comunidad. Necesitamos ser escuchados y que hagan algo al respecto. Ella no lo está haciendo.
Gracias.
¿Se puede dar sus papeles a la muchacha para que pueda traducirlos, por favor?
Claro que sí.
Gracias.
Gracias.
I would like to ask you guys for the second time that you please hear us and keep in mind everything that has been happening and that you please do something. 2 years ago, we came before you letting you know that, letting you know everything that Jennifer Davis was doing everything that she was doing wrong and against us. She was not following the rules that she was not following the rules of the program. She was not informing us of events about the program and much less of how the funds were being used. She did not allow the social worker, Myra Gonzalez, to help us. Or to offer us services. Since she started with the program, she did not allow us to visit homes when before, when Rita Gomez was there before, she would always let Myra do her job. How it should be, and help all the families in need. This lady, Myra Gonzalez, has done her job for 27 years. She knows what she's doing. And this lady, Jennifer, took away her offices at each school site, which were already very small, but she had a space where she can provide us services and help and talk with us about problems and any necessities in privacy. She would always listen to us. She would keep things confidential and she would do everything to help us. We found out, and there's proof that they took away 3 offices from Myra without even letting her know. They threw away all her stuff. They threw all her stuff on the floor and they let her go. They broke her stuff and everything was lost. Everything that she had personal in each office, which was done on behalf of Jennifer Davis. It seems to us that she is a racist person. With us, she has behaved in a manner with, she has behaved in a racist manner. She looks at us as if we are less. And what our opinion is doesn't matter. She's never taken us into account, any of our necessities or opinions. One more time, I'm asking you guys that you guys listen to us and that you remove her from the program. because she is not doing anything for the families. She is not doing for anything in the for the families in the program. Actually, each family that comes in, she is interrogating them and investigating them. And one way or another, she has found a way to get rid of them and speak bad on behalf of Myra Gonzalez to us, saying she is not doing her job when she has so many years of doing it and helping the families. Please give Jennifer Davis's job to a person that is going to listen to us and hear our necessities, is going to help us, and will offer a translator in the meetings so that we can understand, and that she not be racist with us because the majority of us are Hispanic. We are not in agreement that Mr. Jose Quintero continues in the program. He doesn't do anything for us. He is on Jennifer Davis's side. He is on Jennifer Davis's side. His salary is very high. He has a high salary, and this money can be used and utilized for the children. This time we hope that something is done and that you remove Jennifer Davis and Jose Quintero from the program, and that you put someone there that will comprehend us, will understand the way of doing things, understand our necessities, so that we can soon see the change, and that this program, so that this program can keep helping families in need. Thank you, Lourdes Herrera.
Guillermo Farias.
He has the option of letting her read it.
Estimada mesa directiva, por medio de la presente, me dirijo a ustedes para pedir que por favor se nos escuche y que nos ayuden a rescatar el programa migrante. Por favor, escuchen y tomen cartas por todo lo que está sucediendo para que hagan algo al respecto. I think it might be easier if I say read it and then. Dear school, on behalf of what is going on, I would like to ask you guys that you hear us and that you help us save the migrant program. Please hear us, take notes with everything that is happening. Hemos sido ignorados por 2 años haciendo peticiones y encargándoles que ayuden a rescatar el programa migrante. We have been ignored for 2 years. We have been ignored for 2 years. We have made petitions and have put it in your hands to help us save the migrant program. La señora Jennifer Davis ha estado haciendo mal en contra de todos nosotros. No ha estado siguiendo los reglamentos del programa, por lo cual nadie ha sabido de qué manera se ha gastado dinero del programa. Jennifer Davis has not been doing her job and has been against us. She has not been following the rules, and we have not known how the funds are being wasted of the program. Se le ha prohibido a la señora Mayra González que deje brindar los servicios que ella por muchos años los ha hecho. She has not allowed Mayra González to give the services that she has done for many years. Se le ha prohibido visitar nuestras casas cuando por muchos años hemos tenido el apoyo y la ayuda. She has not been allowed to visit our homes when for many years we have had that support and that help. From Mayra Gonzalez, de la señora Mayra Gonzalez. Es por eso que le pedimos a la mesa directiva que tome cartas en el asunto. That is why we ask that you please address this issue. Las necesidades del programa migrante son muchas y hemos mirado que la señora Jennifer Davis no está haciendo nada por las familias del programa. The necessities of the migrant program is a lot, and we've seen that Jennifer Davis has not done anything for the families of the program. Es por eso que le pedimos a la mesa directiva que dejen trabajar a la señora Mayra González para hacer y desempeñar la labor que ha hecho por muchos años. That is why we ask that you please allow Mayra González to work so that she can do the job that she's done for many years. Es por eso que acudimos a la mesa directiva para pedir que de una manera y otra ayuden a demostrar que la señora Davis es una persona demasiado racista. That is why we are asking the board that you help us prove that Jennifer Davis is a racist person. Thank you. Gracias atentamente, Guillermo Farras.
Maritza Pineda.
Hi, so per Mr. Mullen, I have 10 minutes since I'll be doing it in English and Spanish. It starts now. Okay, so mi nombre es Maritza Pineda. Soy una madre que estuvo en el programa migrante y decidí pararme a hablar porque muchos temas que están mencionando ahorita sobre el migrante, la señora Ríos parece que está escuchándolo por primera vez. Cuando usted y el señor Mullen vinieron al programa migrante a los padres hace 2 años para decirnos que la señora Davis no estaba haciendo el programa, corriendo el programa bien. No me mires así porque sabes que es cierto. It's not a town hall, so you cannot be talking. This is my time, so you wait. So, cuando estaba eso pasando hace 2 años, tuvimos otra mesa directiva. Esa mesa directiva nos dio un town hall meeting. Luego, en esa mesa directiva estaba ahí la señora Davis contestando preguntas. Vinieron del condado, del migrante del condado, contestaron preguntas a los padres del programa migrante. Hubo una resolución, fue cuando se hizo una mesa directiva de padres con la señora Davis. Yo estuve en esa mesa directiva. Vimos cómo se manejaban los fondos, cómo se estaban usando en los programas, qué programas estaba usando, y ayudamos con ella a hacer el programa, el plan de gastos del programa. Estaban varios padres que siempre están involucrados en las escuelas. No era nada más yo, era la señora María Cruz, era la señora Alejandra Ibarra, eran varios padres que siempre están involucrados. También vinieron con esa moción, que la señora Davis era una señora racista. Si la señora Davis es una señora racista, ¿por qué durante la pandemia ayudó a darle a los padres que no calificaban para migrante, darles canastas con el señor Q? Agarraron tarjetas de comida de las tiendas de Albertson para darle a las familias necesitadas, para que tuvieran algo que comer con sus hijos. So, cuando vienen aquí y empiezan a decir esas cosas, no es justo. Porque si ese es el caso que ellos tienen problemas con el migrante, hagan otra junta de town hall meeting para que vengan otra vez y expresen sus problemas o lo que están ellos diciendo que está pasando. La señora Mayra Gómez es muy buena en su trabajo. Nadie dice que no lo es. La señora Mayra ha ayudado a muchas familias. Nadie lo ha dicho que no lo hace. Pero también cuando ella lleva, nos explicaron eso los señores del condado, que cuando ella lleva agentes personales en su carro personal, el programa, la escuela del, school district del Fairfax están en riesgo de ser también demandados si se ponen en un accidente, porque ella es una empleada del distrito. Ahora, ¿qué quieren que salven al programa migrante? ¿Por qué no la prioridad es salvar a la escuela? ¿Por qué no la prioridad es salvar los fondos generales de los niños? Donde es que se paga la educación de ellos. El programa migrante es más ayuda para los niños que no tienen padres que les puedan ayudar en su casa. No es para que los lleven a pasear, eso es extra. Pero la educación de tu hijo viene de los fondos del distrito escolar, los que se están gastando ustedes en las oficinas de abogados. Esos $203,000 que se gastaron en, lo dijeron la semana pasada, hace dos semanas, esos $203,000 que se han gastado en servicios legales son los fondos que se podían usar para la escuela, para los estudiantes, para la educación de sus hijos. No el migrante. El migrante es nada más una ayuda, no es la educación. Tu hijo no viene a la escuela migrante, tu hijo viene a la escuela Fairfax School District. Señor Tapia, ahí están sus padres del programa migrante pidiéndole ayuda para salvar al programa migrante, que usted dijo que iba a apoyar al programa migrante. Ahí están los padres que vinieron a pedirle la ayuda. En vez de estar gastando ese dinero en abogados, ayúdeles para que se vayan ciertos fondos para el migrante. Vienen a quejarse a cosas que no vienen al tema, porque el migrante es un programa que se ofrece. El programa se ofrece por el condado. Si son padres de migrantes, saben que el dinero viene del condado, no viene del distrito. El distrito pone una parte para cubrir. No, I still have time.
That we could translate because you only have 5 minutes.
Okay, so I'll translate right now. Everything you say. So back now, I'm going to say it in English. So there's parents coming here saying that the migrant program needs to be saved. And Ms. Rios acts or makes eyes, because we can't even see her facial expressions. She moves her eyes back and forth as if it's the first time she's hearing about this. This is an issue that had been in the board in this district 2 years ago. I was part of the parent migrant program when this was going on. And you came to us and Mr. Molin came to us as parents. Yeah, look at him, because you know I'm telling the truth. You two came to speak to the parents to tell us that Ms. Davis was not running the program correctly. That Ms. Davis, you cannot speak. That. You cannot speak. It's not a town hall meeting. See, you want to speak, you make a town hall meeting. I'm going to get an extra minute because you're interrupting me. Yes. So, like I was saying, you guys came to us and spoke to us. We did. We had a town hall meeting. A resolution came about. In that town hall meeting, people from the migrant program in the county came. And they actually gave us all the information that was given and how the program was to be run. And yes, Ms. Davis had not had a committee of parents to consult with and help her with the how the budget of the migrant program was supposed to be done. We did that. We had a parent, she formed a parent committee. She formed where we did the budget. I was part of that. A couple of parents of the migrant program that are always involved were there too. When nobody is saying that Ms. Mayra Gonzalez is not a good teacher, a good person that doesn't run the program right. Nobody's saying that. She does. She does a good job. She has done a good job. Nobody's saying that she doesn't. But when we had a town hall meeting, we were also told that when she takes people to their personal appointments, doctor appointments in her personal vehicle, the school district is liable if she gets into an accident due to the fact that she's an employee of the Fairfax School District. Therefore, they can be sued. So when parents come here and they express this without really knowing, because they are not really involved, because if they were really involved, they would know all this. If they are in the migrant program, they go to the county office for training, for classes on Saturdays. I've been there. I am a parent from the migrant program. And they know only certain things come. Now, there's parents here fighting for the migrant program. Why don't you come and fight for the actual school, for the district? Because that's where your kids get their education. They don't get it through the migrant program. The migrant program is just to aid them because they don't have that extra help at home. That's what it is. Yeah, they get field trips or they get to go to do events because of the migrant program. That's extra. That's not their actual program. And Mr. Tapia, I was stating, these are your people from the migrant program that came to you when you said that you were going to work for them and do stuff for them. Here it is. Don't spend the $203,000 in legal fees. Spend them to help them with the migrant program. That's why they're here, because they want you to work for them. I still have time. I have my timer. Right, yeah. But it's my time.
I'm not telling you.
So this is the people that you said you were gonna help them to have that extra help and not spend that money and the legal fees that we are not supposed to be paying as taxpayers. I want my child, my three kids right here, to have a good education. That's what I want. That's why my parents came from Mexico, so that I can have a better life and so that their descendants can have a better life. So my kids can have a career. Thank you.
I want to say something. I love migrant community. I love you guys. Thank you. We're going to close session at 7:11. Do I have a first? Oh, okay.
I didn't hear what you said.